Captain. Stardate 6088.1. We have successfully driven off our assailants. Major damage has been sustained by our warp engines. Communications has reported that USS Enterprise is in sector. I requested Mr. Scott's assistance in repairing damage to the Republic. With luck, we will be fully operational in a couple of days.
And they're off helping. Are we in the future? Because Scotty went off to help another ship while we're on this ship, but Scotty went to help this ship. I don't know.
Nothing happens.
I wouldn't be surprised though.
Nothing happens.
Alright, we need power to this.
The unit doesn't generate enough power to run any of the major systems. Main or auxiliary power is required for that, Captain.
These are the auxiliary helm and navigation controls for the Republic. Though they are intact, the ship is in no condition to move under her own power.
Nothing to report, Captain. This input-output slot for the record decks is still functional, Captain.
Whatever would give you that idea, Spock?
These are the auxiliary helm and navigation controls.
The impulse power allocation controls are functional, but there is no power available, Captain.
Mr. Spock, what is the status of the ship's computer?
There is extensive damage to the main processing unit of the ship's computer. It will take several days at a starbase to repair.
We don't have several days, Mr. Spock.
Unless we can find a suitable computational alternative, there will be no way to control the ship's systems.
That's just great, Spock. We don't exactly carry an M5 computer in our inventory.
Correct, Doctor. However, there may be another alternative.
Well, they're all
linked
pissed at him.
Tricorders, along with the circuits in the data reader, should have the processing power necessary to control a single starship system.
Thank goodness for parallel processing. I don't know what computers could do without it.
Really?
I believe nothing needs to be said, Captain.
If there's anything I can do, sir, just ask.
I'm glad this isn't the Enterprise.
What a mess. I wonder what we can do to fix this.
Spock wishes that Mr. Scott were here. Ensign Keege doesn't see the need for a security escort. McCoy wishes that Mr. Scott were here.
What about you, Kirk? Do you wish Mr. Scott were here?
Kirk is dismayed by the damage that was done to auxiliary control.
He's busy being dismayed. Right. Attach phasers.
Spock, what is the situation with the impulse engines?
There is currently no...
phasers? Wait.
Captain, it would be unwise to use your phaser consider... Captain, it would be un...
Wait, what did he say about it? Not phasers, but... tricorders?
These are the auxiliary helm and...
This input-output slot for the...
I just want to hear what he says again.
Mr. Spock, what is the status?
There is extensive damage to...
We don't have several...
Unless we can find a suitable computational alternative, there will be no way to...
That's just...
Correct, Doctor. However, there may be another alternative. Linked tricorders, along with the circuits in the data reader, should have the processing power necessary to control a single starship system.
Thank goodness for parallel pro...
The data reader...
This is the impulse indicators currently. Damage from the battle has... These are the auxiliary helm and navigation controls for the Republic. Though they are intact, the ship is in no...
Mr. Spock, what is the status?
There is extensive...
We don't have...
Unless...
That's just...
Correct, Doctor.
Thank goodness for...
Mr. Spock, what is the status?
There is extensive...
We don't have several...
Unless we can...
That's just great.
Correct, Doctor.
Thank goodness for parallel...
I'm a doctor, not a computer scientist.
Ha ha ha.
I certainly see nothing there calling for a ship's doctor.
There is nothing at the moment for me to do there. Spock, what is the situation?
There is currently no...
There is nothing at the moment for me to do there.
Hmm. Link the tricorders, but I'm not sure how to do that. Oh, we use it here. Oh, well, that makes sense. Looks
Captain,
like he's attaching it to him.
Journals. According to Chapter 18, we can run...
Jim, do we really need a lesson in starship engineering?
Spock, just tell me if they will help.
Why, yes, Captain.
Do we know what to do now?
I have memorized all pertinent data, Captain. There is no need to re-examine the journals.
This is the Republic's...
Well, I guess since we know what to do now with that, we can restore power back in engineering. Which is here.
This turbo lift cannot reach that area of the ship.
Oh, bother. Where do we switch over again? Where are we now? We're at, we're at auxiliary control. We switch from sick bay, right. And we use this lift to go here. Mr. Spock, since you've memorized everything...
Please select an impedance.
Spock?
Captain, the information obtained from the engineering journals indicates the correct impedance setting to be 19,000 ohms.
Go ahead and adjust the setting, Spock.
19,000. Just in case I have to set it.
Power has now been restored, Captain.
Okay, good. Cool. Now what do you have to say for yourself?
There has been a point...
Yeah. Okay, so we've got power.
I fail to see the logic in that action, Captain. The regulator is fully operating from the power tap run from the impulse engines. We can allocate power to ship systems in auxiliary control.
Okay, does that mean we can go to, I guess, transporter and go somewhere else? Save for a while.
Save new game. Replace.
Will this work now?
Captain, there is no power allocated to the transporter.
Can we use the power pack with that?
Nothing happens. Nothing happens.
Spock, would it be possible to connect the fusion power pack directly into the transporter power circuits?
Fascinating. It can be done. However, the transporter will only be able to transport a single person.
Do it, Spock.
Cool. Where can we go?
Fail to see the logic in that action, Captain.
Beam me. Thank you.
This unit is fully functional, but I do not see the logic in using it at this time, Captain. The Enterprise is out of range for transport.
Oh. I wanted to use it to teleport possibly somewhere else on the ship. Never mind. Hmm. I guess we're going to auxiliary. This is destroyed here.
This turbo lift cannot...
Oh, bother.
Save new game. Replace previous game.
Well, it sounds like a bridge now.
This is the Republic's auxiliary. Damage from the battle has disabled. This is the impulse power. Indicators show impulse power online, but no power allocated to any systems. This is the fire control for the photon torpedoes. A red flashing light is currently indicating a jam in the torpedo loading mechanism.
Captain, the torpedo loading system is malfunctioning. To clear it, we will have to physically examine the mechanism. Currently, all turbo lift access to the torpedo bay is blocked by a hull breach. Fortunately, it is highly unlikely that we will need this ship's weapons systems.
These are the auxiliary helm and navigation controls for the Republic. Though they are intact, the ship is in no condition to move under her own power.
We got these lit up.
This is the auxiliary ship damage display. Red flashing damage indicators dominate its surface. This is the auxiliary control. This is the Republic. This is the Republic's.
Okay, so we can allocate power to systems here.
Spock, what is the situation with the impulse engines?
The main computer is too badly damaged to actively control the power circuits.
These are the auxiliary helm and navigation. These are the auxiliary... Spock crudely attaches the science tricorder to the computer console.
Okay, good. So now we need his tricorder.
Spock crudely attaches the medical tricorder to the computer console.
He took it from
him. Tricorders are rigged into the main computer's central processing unit. We now have enough computational power to control a single ship's system.
Okay. And what system should that be?
Captain, look! An Elasi ship!
That ship was cloaked.
Fascinating.
Is that all you can say?
Captain, I suggest we try to raise the shields.
Yeah. Shields.
I certainly see nothing.
Mr. Spock, what is the condition?
There is no power, Alec.
These are the auxiliary helm and nap.
How do I raise shields?
With impulse power online, and the tricorders performing computer control, I can divert power to...
Weapons. Shields.
Shields.
Transporters. Weapons. Shields.
Shields are up, sir.
Captain, we are being hailed by the Elasi captain.
Put it on screen, Spock.
Well, if it isn't Captain Kirk. Fancy meeting you out here all alone in such a shabby starship.
Yeah, how about that?
You should be more civil, considering your Enterprise is far away on a mercy mission helping that poor traitor.
It was a setup?
I can see why they made you, Captain.
I assume since you haven't blasted us to bits, you want something.
Why, yes I do. It seems you failed to give one of my associates some rather important information.
The Mastada, I presume. You want the locations of all your imprisoned comrades?
Oh,
yes,
that guy.
Kirk. The Republic's computers will have the data just as your Enterprise would. I give you 1 minute to comply.
Just try and get it. You can't threaten me. It will take time. The controls are smashed and the main computer's badly damaged. It will take hours to get power to the computer banks.
Good answer.
Just try and get it. You can't threaten. It will take time.
Maybe I should just pump a few torpedoes into your shields and check it out for myself.
The Republic will fall apart if you fire on us. Then you'll never get the data.
All right, Kirk. We'll do it your way. I would rather not kill you. Besides, there's an old friend that wants to meet you. I give you 30 minutes. And remember, no tricks.
Captain, the main computer is far beyond.
Shut up, Spock.
30 minutes, then. Kirk out.
So what are we supposed to do exactly?
An Elasi frigate is visible on the view screen. Though silent now, you know it is ready to attack at a moment's notice.
Fascinating. A cloaked Elasi.
I'm not one to overlook strategic implications, Mr. Spock, but we can save that for another time. We don't have much time for talk. The Elasi are known for their punctuality.
Captain, do you suppose the Elasi might have used cloaking technology to project a false image of a ship the Republic would trust?
That is beyond the Elasi's capabilities, Ensign.
Cloaked Elasi. I wonder who the old friend they mentioned is.
I don't know, Bones.
Well, the one we killed?
With impulse power online and the tricorder's performing computer control, I can divert power to...
Weapons. Shields. Transporter circuits. Weapons.
Weapons?
Captain, the Elasi can surely detect the lowering of our shields. They will undoubtedly try to board us if we lower them. With impulse power online and the tricorder's...
Weapons. Shields. Transporter circuits.
Captain, the Elasi can surely detect the lowering of our shields. They will undoubtedly try to board us if we lower them.
Spock, what about the fusion power pack? Could we use it to power the transporter?
I believe so, Captain. It would require a connection to the transporter circuits in the main control console.
That's what I tried to do. What's the point of even being able to use this on this power pack?
Transporter systems are operational, Captain. Coordinates have been set to the photon torpedo loading bay.
I love you, Spock. Engage.
This is the only access to the torpedo bay, Captain.
Go.
Ensign Keege, I want you to beam into the torpedo bay and unjam the loading mechanism.
Oh, the ensign.
If you don't succeed, we'll all be on permanent shore leave in an Elasi jail.
I'll do my best, sir.
Do it, Spock.
I'm just standing here for, you know, moral support.
I've reached the torpedo loading bay, Captain. It's not too badly damaged, fortunately.
What's causing the malfunction in the loading mechanism?
The inner loading door is stuck in a closed position. Now, I can force it open, but when the loading cycle has begun, the room will lose pressure. We won't be able to beam back here again.
Do it, Ensign. We'll just have to gamble that the system doesn't jam again.
The door's open, Captain. I'm ready to transport back.
Beam him back, Spock.
That worked? I'm gonna make a new save, because I'm not sure.
Save new game.
What was I calling it? 18? Okay.
I did good, didn't I, sir?
No, you did well, Ensign.
I'm a security officer, not a grammarian.
What's a grammarian?
A very efficient job, Captain.
Now let's give the Elasi something to remember us by.
Shall we give the Elasi our transmission, Jim?
Let's get back to auxiliary control and give them our information.
Give them our information. Okay. Yeah, photon torpedoes. I mean, these aren't the ones, the boosted ones from the Enterprise. But, yeah, that should be pretty devastating. Okay.
This is the photon torpedo launching control.
Pleased to use.
Mr. Spock, what is the condition of the fire control system?
There is no power allocated to the weapon system, Captain.
Oh, we have to allocate power and then shoot. And they'll see we gotta get it before they beam aboard, because we have to lower... We have to take power from the shields to do it, right? Unless we get the power pack up here, I just save. Let's try it this way. I'll be quick.
With impulse power online.
Weapons. Shields. Transport weapons.
Captain, the Elasi can surely detect the lowering of our shields. They will undoubtedly try to board us if we lower them.
Oh, they're not gonna let us? He's not gonna let us?
This is the photon torpedo launching control.
Save new game. Replay. You get no response.
Oh, hail Elasi. Hail Enterprise.
They are jamming all frequencies, Captain. We will not be able to contact the Enterprise.
Well, Captain Kirk, I trust you and your valiant crew have retrieved all the right data I requested.
Not yet. We're having trouble accessing all the data files. Yes, we have. You'll have to beam over and get it, though. The computer's subspace transmitter is out. Not yet. We're having trouble accessing... Yes, we have. You'll have to beam over and get it, though. The computer's subspace transmitter is out.
Beam over and get it? We want to destroy their ship.
How convenient, Kirk. We'll beam over, but no tricks. My sensors read that only your shields have power. Lower them now.
We'll comply. Kirk out.
Can I just... do it automatically?
Mr. Spock, what is the condition of the fire control system?
There is no power allocated to the weapon system, Captain.
All right.
With impulse power online, and the tricorders perform...
Weapons.
Power allocated to weapon systems, Captain.
Sensors indicate that the Elasi ship has lowered its shields. I suggest we prepare your surprise soon, Captain. They will beam over any moment.
Okay, go. Ooh. Awesome! Yay!
Kirk, I should have known you'd try something underhanded like this. Weapons master, fire all weapons on the Republic!
We can, Captain. All weapon systems offline.
Sweet.
Captain, the Enterprise is coming on high-speed approach.
Oh.
Activate cloaking device. Kirk, until we meet again.
Not too soon, I hope.
Watch yourself, Captain. It may be sooner than you realize.
Why do you guys always have the same beard?
Are you safe, sir?
We're fine, Lieutenant.
Sir, we picked up another ship nearby and we came as fast as we could. It appeared to cloak. Were you attacked by Romulans?
Nope.
No, Ensign. It looks like the Elasi have been doing some business with them. Scotty, beam us back. We need to find that ship that attacked the Republic.
Aye, Captain.
Cool. I sense the end is near. He never looks up at them. He should look up at them to make sure they're materializing correctly.
Captain's log, Stargate 6089.6. We are in pursuit of the starship that destroyed the Republic. Its trail is leading us to the planet Vardane, a member of the Federation whose motives have not always matched the high ideals of other Federation cultures.
Captain, I did not expect to hear you judge an entire culture. I understand the Republic.
I had bad experiences with the Vardane long ago, Mr. Spock.
Fascinating. Captain, I am reading a Constitution-class starship heading for Vardane at warp factor 5.
Captain, its transponder codes match ours.
Sensors indicate it is an exact duplicate of the Enterprise, including hull markings.
Open hailing frequencies. Increase to warp factor 8. Send a message to Starfleet. Open hailing frequencies.
Hailing frequencies.
Captain Kirk, this is the Enterprise 2. I am Dr. Ez Bridell of the Verdane Defense Force. You do remember me, don't you, Captain?
I remember you. 10 years ago, when I was on the Farragut, we exposed your unethical practices to the Verdane Council.
The old Verdane Council. Politics is such a fickle business. A new one is much less concerned with trivial concerns.
Concerned with concerns?
I remember your part in my disgrace, which is why when we began to construct our own Constitution-class ships, I insisted that we have our own Enterprise.
How did you manage to build a Constitution-class ship? You have 10 seconds to lower your shields and power down your weapons, or we will fire. You won't get away with this. The Verdane can't honestly expect to take on the entire Federation. How did you manage to build a Constitution-class ship?
Yeah, curious.
Our intelligence network is better than yours, Captain.
Oh,
how else does one gather secret information?
You are a member of the Federation. You have signed Federation treaties.
And we shall break them. The Federation's interference in our internal affairs is intolerable.
You must have been building that ship long before the Turgon crisis.
Captain, all wars require justification. They aren't supposed to be fun. You have your justification and I have mine. Don't take diplomacy so seriously. However, Captain, I do intend to enjoy myself. I do intend to enjoy seeing Lieutenant Kirk's ship go up in flames. I shall laugh at the sight.
How
we'll
sweet.
See who gets the last laugh, Bridell.
He's such a sweet little guy.
I'm sure you would. You're a fool, Bridell. You can't defeat a trained Federation crew unless you ambush them. We'll see who gets the last laugh. I'm sure you would.
I'm sure you would.
I have noted that the Federation enjoys talking, Captain.
Uh-oh.
You may talk yourself to your grave. Prepare to be destroyed.